Hello, and welcome to another YFA Pro Tip. My name is Dan Landerman. Today we're going to talk about creating automatic backups of your YFA system within the Eaton Feeder Automation Manager. So here you can see the manager on my screen, and I have navigated to the Options tab, and then the one that says Backup here. And this is where you can set up automatic backups of your system. The first thing we have to do is determine what our backup location is going to be. So in this case, I already created one, but we'll now browse to it. I'm going to come into my PC, C drive, and here it is, YFA backups. I'm going to click OK, and now we have YFA backups. You can see the error on the screen goes away. I'm going to hit apply, make sure that change occurs. Now that I've got the backup location created, we can actually come in and create a backup of the system by hitting the backup button. It will automatically create a backup in that location, and you can do this on a manual basis. This works great if you're not going to set up an automatic backup, but you just want to do it occasionally. It'll generate a backup for you before you do an upgrade or something of that nature. So it's a good idea to occasionally come in and do a backup. It will save all your settings within your Eaton automation, feeder automation system, and it will also save all your site files and other things that might be generated within the system. Now that the backup is complete, I can actually open the location here, and we can see I created a new backup today. You'll notice that these files are quite large, so this one is 313 megabytes roughly. That is a good reason to set up the retention policies down here. You can keep a maximum count of 10 backups or delete any backups that are older than, in this case, 90 days. So good idea to set the retention policies so you're not using up all your hard drive space with old backups that you might have. Once you have it set up for a location and you've verified that you can create a backup, now it's important to go in and create a way to automatically back up the system. I like to do this on my systems, and I use the task scheduler to do it. There's a button right here to enable that. So you hit click on this button, and the task scheduler will come up. Here's the task scheduler I have. We are going to come over here to the right-hand side, and we're going to create a basic task. And now we have a task, and I'm going to call it YFA Backups. Click Next. And how often do you want to do this? We can do this daily, weekly. I'm going to do a daily example. You might want to create one daily. You might want to do it weekly. You might want to do a monthly backup. I like to do them on a daily basis and then set the retention policy so I only retain so many. So I'm going to create a daily backup here. Click Next. When do you want it to occur? Start today. But we can do this, let's do it at like 10 o'clock at night, and we'll do it at 10 p.m. Occurs every one day, so it's easy enough to do. And what do we want to do? We actually want to start a program to do this. So we're automatically going to create the backup by starting a program. And what is that particular line that we need to type in? Well, you need to find a particular program, and it is going to be c:\backslash/cooper-power-systems/backslash-eukon-feeder-automation/backslash-manager-client/backslash-eukon.feeder-automation.manager.command-line.exe. And then additional arguments. Here we have to do a forward slash backup. So, and I'm going to do that with a lowercase b. And this tells it, okay, run this program in a command line with this additional argument. We're going to hit Next. So it's going to start it every day. And we can do Finish. We can then open the task scheduler library up here in the upper left-hand corner and see that our task, YFA Backups, is created right here. On the right-hand side, you can then run this task scheduler to get it to operate. And I've already done that to test it. You hit run, and you can kind of see it starts the task, creates a task, and then the task is completed right here. And then we can go back into the Eaton Feeder Automation Manager, open the location, and we can see that our new backup has been created right here after we ran it. So here's the latest one we created. I hope this YFA Pro Tip was useful to you, showing you how you can use the task scheduler to create an automatic backup on a schedule. If you like this video, please hit like button and look forward to more YFA Pro Tips in the future. Thank you. Goodbye.